What y'all got?
Biggest raspberry in the world.
Not raspberry.
Blackberries.
Blackberries. Yeah. Show me where you found them.
Mm-hmm. Come here.
Megan, hi. Come here. Where'd you get these little flowers in your hair, baby?
I pulled some off.
Wait. That is absolute. And you didn't do that on purpose?
No, I did that.
Oh, you put them in her hair?
Yeah, I pulled them and then I sprinkled them all over.
That's perfect. Looks great.
Yeah, she sprinkled everyone.
It's right here. Yeah, that's where I saw them yesterday.
It's a tap for all of them.
Oh, there's still some left. There's one over here, too.
Look at this big one.
Yep.
Wait, Ethan, compare yours to mine. Okay, yours is
blackberries, berries.
I was like, oh.
Well, they're all the same berry. It's just the other ones have gotten more ripe.
Okay, Daddy, should we?
Well, I tell you, in the springtime, we used to get those all the time, huh?
Should we keep these?
You can eat them, yeah.
No.
You got food on your stomach. It won't make your stomach too... Oh! The mother load.
Oh! Let's pick some. Pick them. Like, I meant like...
Oh, here's a good one right here.
Hmm? Daddy, what I meant was like clean them and then like put them in a
bowl.
Oh,
there's some good ones on this side too. Just go around, Ethan. There's a whole sticker bush right here. I'm going to go show them how our fruit's coming along. Mmm, the flowers smell good.
Can I go get a bowl?
I never knew we had fruit.
Yeah, we got pears. You know that.
Pears?
We used to have an apple tree.
Where's pear now?
Right here.
Is this a pear tree?
Of course it is. You've eaten pears off of this tree before. Many times.
Oh, Mom, when are you the first pear?
Well, they're not ready yet.
Oh. You're so little, Daddy.
Daddy, can I go get a bowl from inside?
Yes. Got honeysuckle over there. But these little flowers, they bloom in the spring, and they smell so good. It smells like gardenia, jasmine type. But that's what's in Megan's hair right now. He probably just grabbed the whole thing and threw it at her. Oh, wow. Man, I wish I could put your smell-o-vision on right now. This smells amazing. Here's the honeysuckle. This is only one time a year, guys. I don't know why this leaf over here is just doing the happy dance. But he is tripping out. There must be a bug on it. I really gotta stop that and see what's going on. That was kind of freaking me out a little bit. It was like, there is a slight breeze moving through here, as you can, it's that slight, but not enough to make that thing doing that number. The trees are alive. Smell of those honey smuckles. I can't talk today. Must have been that tincture. There's that breeze. Yum, yum. Just pinch the bottom of it, and there it is. Oh my God. If you've never lived in the country and ever tasted the taste of a honeysuckle, it is a very, very, very brief euphoria. You get just a taste of heaven. If you had a whole spoon of it, it would probably be way too much. But being that it's such a small amount of nectar, it is just the right amount. And being that you're outdoors, a lot of people don't know this, the fresh air from outdoors makes it taste even better. That is the absolute truth. Fresh air from outside makes the palate taste food a lot fresher. This is a full acre in the backyard. It's a rural acre. It's what we call a country acre. It's a difference between the city and the country. The acreage is smaller in the city.
Look how good they look.
Oh, yeah. Good. A lot of people don't know that. Actually, our realtor in Texas didn't know that. So we were kind of wondering if that's a Louisiana thing. I don't know. But it's an actual fact. You get a larger plot in the country, in the rural area, than you do the city when you get it by acreage. This tree used to just be a stick. My ex-wife, Tristan and Braden's mom, grabbed one of these from another place, stuck it in the ground, and this became over years. And it didn't really take that long. I've pruned this down like every year, and it comes back this big. I chop it all the way down every year. You can see where I chopped it last year. All this, I chop it all off, and then it comes right back. This is one of those no-kill-ems. There's your bird's nest. And over here we have, this rose bush has been here. We planted that when we moved in 2000. And no, actually we did not plant this. This was already here. That's right. This was already here. It just rejuvenates every year. Just keeps on keeping on. This video was not intended to be what it is, but we're making it happen anyway. Oh, here's one for you to try, Ethan. A nice green one. No. That'll make you pucker up. But over here, this, I got a good story about that. When my dad passed away in 2016, my aunts were hell-bent on me buying a plant or flower to bring to the funeral. We went to the flower shop, and they picked out a stupid amount of money of plants. And this one was $50-something dollars. At the end of the funeral, they were going to be throwing them out, and I'm just like, no. My dad didn't care nothing about flowers to begin with, but I'll be damned if y'all gonna throw a $50 plant in the trash. It's an indoor plant, but I planted up here under this awning, and it's been here ever since. 3 years ago when we had that deep freeze, it was below zero, it died, and it didn't come back the next year, but the following year it came back. Can you believe that? That's how strong the roots are. It came back a year after the season. Here's you some more. There's a blackberry right down there.
Oh, this one's so good.
Yeah, and here's a blackberry. And there's another one over there. Wow. Have you seen any lizards?
Nope.
No frogs?
Nope, I did see a big spider.
Keep an eye out. There's always one hanging out right around here.
There's this weird white thing.
Oh, that's bull nettle. Don't touch it. I promise you, you'll only touch it once.
Where's Ethan?
Marcia, Marcia, Marcia.
There's one creepy one.
This came from Turner Falls in Oklahoma. This cactus here. So yeah, it's been spreading. Oh wow, it came like that? That means that something's been eating on it. Yuck. This monkey grass came from my dad's. And this came from Texas. There's a story about all this stuff that's up in here. Everything's got a story. And this one's a dwarf. I gotta try. Ooh! Ethan, Megan. You're missing out. Yeah, but this one's a dwarf here. And I had dug it up from my dad's. My mom planted that when I was a baby. Because I was born in Texas. I wasn't born in Louisiana. And so when we sold the house, I didn't want this to go with the house. So I dug it up and I transplanted it at my mom's. Well, last year, she wanted me to bring it out here. And I did, and I transplanted it here. What's up? No. Look at no, I mean, what's up?
What's up? Oh. Don't get the green one.
Oh, no story with these guys. They were always just here, wild. I just love them. Mama's going to explain to us the rural acre, or farmer acre, you say?
A farmer acre.
Farmer acre, as opposed to a city acre difference. Mm-hmm. Okay, we're out in the country right now. And what is it out here, Mama?
240 by 240 or 220.
220, a feet, square feet?
Feet.
Okay, feet. And in town, it's
180 by 180.
Okay, 180 as opposed to 220 or 240.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, all right. So that
farmer acres, a few more feet.
Larger, yeah, because you get larger in the
that's
larger
right.
area for farming mm-hmm. in the country. Okay, and that's where that came
220.
From. Is that just a Louisiana thing, or is that all over? Do you know?
I do not know.
Because our realtor, and I'm going to show her this, so she'll know. And I did actually Google it and showed her on Google. But it had a little different terminology on Google as opposed to what we would have. But
plans out. We can make sure.
Yeah. No, well, I mean, you ain't got to go through digging all that. I know y'all had it surveyed not too long ago, but I know that there's a difference because...
220.
Yeah. I know when you get an acre in town, it ain't nothing like out here. Like out here, we have 9 farmer acres, right? And in town, it'd be more like 14, 16 or something like that. But you don't get 14 or 16 in town anyway, so that's irrelevant.
It's 180.
Yeah, so you can do the math. 240 as opposed to 180. Yeah, so it'd be 14.
I don't want to tell nobody wrong. Let me get my deal.
Okay.
Mike.
Okay.
But it's not 240. It's 210 by 210.
210 by 210, so it's not 240.
No,
okay. But the
240
city,
Hammett Drive.
240, I mean, that's where to get the address.
210 by 210. But in town, and see, this is what Mike had this, and this is what I bought.
Yeah.
That's that
mm-hmm.
back.
Uh-huh.
There. This is what Daddy gave me here.
Yeah.
Then I bought this.
Yeah. Okay.
But Mike gave me about 20 extra foot back uh-huh. here.
Well, the town acre is
180.
180. Okay.
Nice.
Okay, so that would be putting it about
so 210.
This may be more like 12 and a half to 13 acres in town then, if you were able to even get that. I got
mm-hmm.
you.
Yeah, but a city lot is, in fact, they go less than 180.
Oh, because of the easement and stuff like that.
That's
yeah,
right.
I know working Center Point Energy, I know
but
a lot
here,
about what they take away from you. You're tracked anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay. Mm-hmm.
See, I got 1 acre. That's this one. See, it's been resurveyed. When Mike sold me this acre back there to go with this, strip, he gave me about 20 extra foot.
Okay. That extra what?
Footage.
Roll that beautiful bean footage.
Footage.
Yeah, see, that's what I was telling you. You bought this one right here, not this one right here. See how the driveway comes in?
It goes this way, baby.
I know, but you were saying you bought this one, and I said, no, Mama, you bought this one.
On the original one,
mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay, yeah. But
yeah.
I got this.
That's that right there. Yes.
Back there, baby.
Back there.
Okay, back there.